हरे कृष्णा, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल ड्रॉपलेट्स ऑफ नेक्टर। टुडेज टॉपिक इज स्कूलिंग ऑफ केदारनाथ श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर। नमो भक्ति विनोदाय सच्चिदानंद नामिने गौर शक्ति स्वरूपाय रूपानुगावराय ते। आई ऑफर माय रेस्पेक्टफुल ओबिसेंसेस एंड टू सच्चिदानंद भक्ति विनोद हु इज ट्रांसेंडेंटल एनर्जी ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु। He is a strict follower of the Goswamis headed by Srila Roop Goswami. In this video, we will be discussing about the schooling of Srila Bhaktivinod Thakur, or who was then known as Kedarnath. Kedarnath's first school was on the veranda of his maternal grandfather's puja building, where many of the village boys used to gather for their education. The teacher was very forbidding and the boys were afraid of them. Bhaktivinod Thakur recalls that school was run by Kartik Sarkar when he was 3 years old. There were many festive occasions observed in the house of his grandfather, especially Durga Puja, also known as Jagat Dhatri Puja, which was performed with great pomp and celebration. Bhaktivinod Thakur recalls hundreds of chandeliers would hang on the puja house, lanterns would be wrapped around all the pillars and columns, and many bodyguards and soldiers used to accompany all the men who were preparing for the festivals. And hence the scene was filled with all kind of celebrations. There were many kavi or the reciters who would scream loudly the glories of Durga Mata. Bhaktivinod Thakur remembers when he was 25 or 30 brahmanas from the west. They carry goddess to the place of worship and they perform worship. And also they enjoyed seeing the killing of the goats and buffaloes. Many goats and buffaloes were sacrificed in the puja. Bhaktivinod Thakur as Kedarnath didn't like it. He many times protested, but he was a child. No one heard of him. Everybody used to enjoy the occasion except the goats and buffaloes. Most of the brahmanas and panditas used to come solely for the taste of mutton. There were dola yatra celebrations and many of the people used to celebrate it by throwing dye and yard singing and all. When Kedarnath was 5 years old, he began his schooling. He used to write ka kha ga on talpat with black coal. After some time, they would write their numbers on banana leaves, and after that they made a copy of paper. All the older boys were taught accounting, which was the work of the office of zamindar. From time to time, under the scrutiny of the teacher, boys would learn the deliberation of a court. They would perform a sample court in their classroom. Young boys would lodge a complaint, and there were witnesses and evidences and the determination of the punishment, and all was guided under the jurisdiction of the teacher who was present there. Up to the end of the 6th year, Kedarnath attended the Bengali medium school, where he studied that the morning by standing loudly the recitation of the tables, or you can say ganda tables, kauri tables, and so on. They would recite 4 kauris make 1 ganda, 4 kauris make 1 ganda, and the thousands of number of times they would recite such. And the teacher would say it, then write it. Then an English school opened in his maternal grandfather's home, which was started by his grandmother. An Indianized Frenchman named Dijor Barrett began to give Kedarnath and his older brother Kali Prasanna some of the other boys' English lessons, and a nice relationship developed between Kedarnath and his teacher. Kedarnath used to sit and talk with the gatekeepers around the villages. The gatekeepers would use to tell him the stories and recite Ramayan, to which Kedarnath was very much attracted, and he began to recite the stories to his mother and maid servant. His mother was very much pleased and sent some gifts to the gatekeepers. In return, the main storyteller would share his rotis, dal, khichdi with Kedarnath. Kedarnath would be very happy. These incidents serves to show how Kedarnath was attracted to hearing about Ram and Krishna from the very beginning of his life. As similar, the Prahlad Maharaj, Uddhava, Narottam Das Thakur, Parikshit Maharaj, they were also in their childhood were not interested in the small dealings of the children. They were interested in the pages of scriptures, and their primary attraction was to God, not for playing. They exhibited it from the very beginning of their lives. Since Kedarnath's mother was the daughter of a very wealthy and respectable man, there was no accomplishment in their house. There were unlimited maid servants and laborers working under them. One of them were Shibu, who took care of Kedarnath most of the time. She was completely dedicated to the brothers, even more than her own children. In the morning time, Shibu would serve as a light breakfast to Kedarnath before going to school. Then she would take them to school. Then she would eat her lunch at noon. Then Kedarnath were taken to some place and they were fed milk. In evening, she would take us home, and Kedarnath was put to bed, and Shibu was himself lying down with him. And in this way, Shibu took care of Kedarnath in the very early periods. On the certain festival occasions, buffalo elephant fights were also being presented in the courtyards of Kedarnath. Sometimes the buffalo would win and sometimes the elephant would win. When Kedarnath was 7 years old, the king of Krishnanagar established a college and invited prominent landholders and neighboring kings to send their sons. Kedarnath, Kali Prasanna, his elder brother, and other boys from their family attended. Their nursemaid accompanied them, and they lived in a house in the midst of bazaar at Krishnanagar. Next door to them lived an oil press man who was about to die. He had arranged for the daily recitation of Mahabharat. Kedarnath very much liked it and regularly heard the stories of Mahabharat from that old man. Then one day, boys ate some impure foodstuffs prepared by a well-meaning relative, and slowly, Kali Prasanna, the elder brother of Kedarnath, became ill with cholera, and in few days he died. Kedarnath's maternal uncle also died because of some inauspicious event, and slowly, many bad things happened in his life after it. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, "There were many men who were revolting against his family. One night, Kedarnath slept, and his father, as he was very tensed by giving the rent to their family members and clearing the debts of his, he also died in that night, and he was taken to Ganges at Shantipur. Bhakti Vinod Thakur recalls, even while father was living, he began to become a little thoughtful. What is this world? Who are we? There were two questions in his mind when he was 10 years old. He would read Ramayana, Mahabharata, Kali Puran, Anand Mangal, etc. from the Bengali manuscripts and imbibed much lore in this way. Like Parikshit Maharaj, he would also take interest in the Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita. At that time, the object of his search was found and his true devotional glories became manifested. A learned man named Vachaspati Mahashaya would often talk to Kedarnath about the spiritual topics. They would desire much and be chanting the holy names of the Lord Ram. He was told, by chanting of the holy names of the Lord Ram, no ghost will trouble him. Hence, to get saved from the ghost at the evening time, Bhakti Vinod Thakur would chant the glories of Lord Ram. Ram, 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 Ram. Like this, he would continuously chant the name of the Lord Ram. He would never give up the name of Ram, which warded away the fear of his ghost. Similarly, he continued to think in a very philosophical way and wrote a poem called Ula Chandi Mahatmya about the deities of Durga at the 11 years of old. Hare Krishna. In this video, on this much. Next video, we will be learning about the marriage and studies of Kedarnath in Calcutta. Hare Krishna.